Hi, I'm Mano Marks. I'm a developer advocate on the Google Maps developer relations team. I'm going to talk to you today about putting driving directions in your Google Maps iOS app using the Google Maps SDK for iOS, and also the Google Geocoding API. So you take a look here at my screen. You'll see that what I've got is a iPad simulator. And I'm just going to click on two different points. And you'll see that it drew a polyline between the two of them. So what we're going to do is walk through that demo. Now, before I do that, I just want to give you a pointer to all the things that this is going to depend on. We are going to be getting an NSData object from data with contents of URL. So this is a standard way of pulling in JSON. And we're going to do that to pull in the Google Geocoding API. we're going to get back an NSJSON serialization object, which we are then going to walk through pulling out data from. Another piece of this that we're going to use is MapView did tap at coordinate. This is just a way to trap the event for when you click, which is what you saw me do in the demo. And we're going to use GMS polyline, polyline with path. We're going to all do this all very quickly. So if you've seen before the shortcut that I did on geocoding and also the one I did on an earthquake tracker, some of this is going to be familiar to you. And you'll see how when I walk through the code. So what I've got here is standard app. I prefixed everything MD for maps directions. I had a little storyboard for putting up my my application. And then you'll see I've got a view MD view controller and MD direction service. So I farmed out to a separate class the MD direction service for trapping in the directions just to make that code a little bit more reusable. And by the way, any code that I show you today, I'm going to put up in GitHub under my personal account. So here we're in the view controller, and you can see what I did here is I created a map view, a dib map at coordinate. And what that does is it takes a coordinate that results from the tap on the map. And that from there, you can pull out a position. And then I create a marker based on that. So this is the position is just a CL location coordinate 2D. And I add that marker to the waypoints array. And I create a position string from each coordinate. So as I tap it, coordinate latitude, coordinate longitude, I just create a string that I then store in the waypoint strings. Because that's going to be easier for constructing a Google geocoding URL. Then I check and see if the count of the number of objects in the waypoint string array is greater than one. And if it is, I then pass in some parameters to the geocoding request. So you see here I'm creating a sensor. And I'm just going to default this to be false because the position that's being detected is not being detected from a sensor. And just to point out, most of you know, sensor in this case doesn't actually give you any additional benefits. It's just our way of tracking whether or not you're using a sensor, so we can report that to our data providers. Then if you look here on, I'm creating a parameters array in which create it with objects sensor and the waypoint strings. So all the strings that have been created up to that point. And then I create a keys object, a keys array, rather, array with objects sensor and waypoints being the two keys. And I pass that as a dictionary to object called query to MD direction service. I also pass to it a selector, add directions, which is going to take care of adding the directions to the map once once I'm done getting the directions. And I pass in the delegate self. This is a standard messaging model in iOS. So what we've got here then is I'm creating the service, and you see here I've got the set directions query with selector and with delegate. And by the way, the reason I'm doing this sort of selector delegate model for messaging is so that I can do an asynchronous call to our geocoding services. It's a little bit different from my last shortcut where I did a synchronous call to the geocoding service. Just want to show you a different way. And generally, when you're calling to web services, you want to do an asynchronous call because that gives your application the opportunity to keep going if the web service takes a while to populate. So here I create an array of waypoints just from the query object to pulling out the waypoints. I get the origin, which is the first one. I count the number of waypoints, and I get the destination, which is the last one. And then I pull out the sensor. Then I create a URL string, which is basically the base URL, which is this here. This is the geocoding API's base URL. And you notice I've used the JSON version of it. You can also use an XML-based version of it. Most developers these days are preferring to use JSON because it's really easy to work with. OK, so then I'm basically creating a new URL string with origin, destination, sensor. And if the waypoint count is more than two, additional waypoints. So you can you can pass to the directions API the ability to track multiple waypoints in directions. That is saying, pass through all these points between the origin and the destination, and then optimize the route, or not, your choice. So then I'm just adding in additional waypoints to the string. And then here I'm using I'm encoding, basically URL encoding the string. And I then, once it's done, retrieve the directions with a particular selector and delegate. So retrieve directions is the next function. So retrieve directions, I pass in the selector and delegate, and basically say, create this data object, and then pass it to the selector and delegate that I've chosen, which brings us back to add directions. So add directions returns this object, this JSON object. And I'm grabbing the object for key routes. So if you look at the direction response, that's sort of the core, the root object. And then I'm finding the route, which is object for key overview polyline. Now, an overview polyline is a way of encoding the directions into a polyline, into a string, which compresses the string greatly over simply creating coordinates for each point along the string. It describes it in a highly dense format, and then GMS path, which is how you create a path in the Maps SDK, then can read that encoded polyline into it and create create a path out of it. Then finally, I create a polyline from that path object and put it onto the map. And that is that's it. Now you can see the optimization happens when I add in additional points along the map. So that's it for this map shortcut. Thank you very much for joining us this week, and we'll see you next week.